Belcher's disease. This is a vasculitis of unknown etiology that characteristically targets small arteries and venules. It is rare in Western Europe, but more common in Silk Road countries around the Mediterranean and in Japan, where there is a strong association with HLA-B51. Oral ulcers are universal. Unlike Aphthous ulcers, they are usually deep and multiple and last for 10 to 30 days. Genital ulcers are also a common problem, occurring in 60 to 80% of cases. The usual skin lesions are erythema nodosum or acneiform lesions, but migratory thromboflebitis and vasculitis also occur. Ocular involvement is common and may include anterior or posterior uveitis or retinal vasculitis. Neurological involvement occurs in 5% and mainly involves the brain stem. Although the meninges, hemispheres, and cord can also be affected, causing pyramidal signs, cranial nerve lesions, brain stem symptoms, or hemiparesis. Recurrent thrombosis also occur. Renal involvement is extremely rare. The diagnosis is primarily made on clinical grounds, but one characteristic feature that can be of diagnostic value is the pathology test, which involves pricking the skin with a needle and looking for evidence of pustule development within 48 hours. Oral ulceration can be managed with topical glucocorticoid preparations, soluble prednisolone mouthwashes, glucocorticoid paste. Colchicine can be effective for erythema nodosum and arthralgia. Thalidomide, 100 to 300 mg per day for 28 days initially, is very effective for resistant oral and genital ulceration, but is teratogenic and neurotoxic. Glucocorticoids and immunosuppressants are indicated for uveitis and neurological disease. Here are the figure showing oral ulceration in Belcher's disease. Now, criteria for the diagnosis of Belcher's disease. Recurrent oral ulceration, minor aphthous, major aphthous, or herpetiform ulceration at least 3 times in 12 months, plus 2 of the following. Recurrent genital ulceration, eye lesions, anterior uveitis, posterior uveitis, cells in vitreous on slit lamp examination, retinal vasculitis. Skin lesions include erythema nodosum, pseudofolliculitis, papulopustular lesions, acneiform nodules. Positive pathology test. Now, relapsing polychondritis. Relapsing polychondritis is a rare inflammatory disease of cartilage that classically presents with acute pain and swelling of one or both ear pinna, sparing the lower non-cartilaginous portion. Around 30% of patients have coexisting autoimmune or connective tissue disease. Involvement of tracheobronchial cartilage leads to a hoarse voice, cough, stridor, or expiratory wheeze. Other manifestations include collapse of the bridge of the nose, scleritis, hearing loss, and cardiac valve dysfunction. Cartilage biopsy shows an inflammatory infiltrate in the perichondrium. Both ESR and CRP are raised in active disease. Pulmonary function tests, including flow volume loops, should be performed to assess the degree of laryngotracheal disease. Since this is an important cause of mortality, mild disease usually responds to low-dose glucocorticoids or NSAIs, whereas major tracheobronchial involvement requires high-dose glucocorticoids and immunosuppressants, as described for SLE.